Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Captive Minecraft 4. Today is the last episode. If you want to see a Beaconator achievement, you should stick around, because that is what we're doing. I'm down here at the skeleton farm that I set up all those years ago. Aw, Sir Meowsalove, what are you doing down here? You are one of my highlights of this series. Either way, I am going back up here. I should take you with me just a little bit here to show you what I have done. As you can hear my skeletons from my highly functional farm. I set up some underground farms. You know, I uploaded a picture to Twitter showing how much materials I had towards the Beaconator achievement. And I was lacking something like 42 blocks, either iron or emerald or whatever. And I've set up this farm down here, if you remember this. Jesus. Here is that old fishing pond I had. I covered it up with some woolly carpet from the sheep upstairs. And don't trample my crops. And I just, while the sugarcane was growing, I set up these. And I should probably show you why in a bit. Actually, I'll do it after. I've done a bit off camera, as much resource gathering as I could towards the beacon, and I suppose I'll just make some sort of montage of what I have done off camera while I have been going towards this achievement. So enjoy. Alright, that takes care of the farm. Let go upstairs. Beautiful segue. And here we are at the farm. I've been breeding up all the animals. And why do you want potatoes, pig? That's not your preferred food. I'm gonna go slaughter up most of these animals as well. I do have looting 3 on my overkill sword now. And as you can tell, I've got a bunch of levels just from... What's here? Something invisible. And I've been trading with villagers. If you guys are familiar with my Captive Minecraft 3 series, then you will know that this is how this works. This is the same thing I did. The only difference is I forgot how much work it was to actually do this. So that's why it's been so long. I also got a mending book from a chest. That's nice. A little late that I found it, but there you go. Can't all have nice things, can we? So I'm gonna go shear up the sheep, I'm gonna kill the cows and the pigs and the chickens, and I'll be right back, guys. There you go, Sir Meowzalot. Back on your cake where you belong. And I've killed most of them. The reason I did that, let's just see that I didn't put away something I need, like leather. Good. Inventory management is a bit of a chaotic mess right now. That's alright. Where did I put all my reeds? Ugh. Alright, I think I'm good to go here. Let's go. So upstairs, up on the top of the world, where we belong, this is what I've done. Hopefully there is an iron golem around here somewhere. No? Jesus, you guys are loud. You remember my little crew of hobbits, right? That I put in this hole over here. Well, the thing is, knowing from experience how things... Man, you guys are so loud. Like, I need to turn down the sound of the... What is it? Blocks? I guess that's the doors. Is it? Maybe? Let's try to see. Doesn't seem to help, does it? What is it? Ambient environment? That sounds about right. Okay. And then you might wonder, why didn't you go into the nether and make like a gold farm instead to get the blocks? Well, I did go into the nether. I did kill a few pigmen. Get a little bit of gold, but that's not my style, guys. I got my stuff back, though. I killed a pigman that stole my armor way, way back, so I'm vindicated. But here's the thing. This is still not growing. It's kind of weird. Ah, free wool. So I made... Hey, little guy. There's a librarian that I need to unlock the first trade with. That's a really good paper trade. He just osmosis. Jesus, did you see that? I guess there's no iron golem here. He usually spawns on the farm or up above, and I've been killing him to get iron. And then you might wonder, well, you could just make an iron farm, and I just can't be arsed, really. Honestly, that's not fun to me. Just sit around AFK for like 5 hours. No, I need something active to do, so that's why I've been going through these trades with the villagers. Cleric, I would have killed you. This trade is terrible. This is a perfect farmer. So he's my guy. Let's get this stuff under way. And yeah, do as many trades as we can here. Perfect. Perfect. Refresh. Hey, dude, what do you want? Books. I can give you books. Let's give the guy what he wants. I don't know how many I would want to do books. I guess as many as possible, right? Because that's a better trade, material-wise, than just paper. I do believe. So let's just do that. So yeah, that's what I did. I put up, I don't know, I got like 40 doors or something so that I won't have problems spawning enough of these guys. And I did trade a bunch of my coal as well. So he's been useful. Where's my preferred guys? There's Fletcher, nice if I had string for like a... what's it called? Spider farm? Leather worker 11? No, I got better guys than you. Hey, what do you want? Doesn't seem like a guy that I need. You, though, are the same librarian. I need my farmer. Here we go. So we're gonna do potatoes next. And as if I've calculated everything correctly, I should not have to go back and replant my farm and all that, which is why I have everything on my person at the moment. Did not unlock, so let's move on to carrots. I'm gonna trade up all my materials here. Please refresh. If not, I'll have to come up with some other way of unlocking him. I could just... Well, that's a shepherd. It's a different farmer, but he has a good carrot trade, so let's just utilize that instead. Very nice. 32. So as you can tell, doing this, you get a ton of emeralds, so... If you have a huge farm, you can just go back up, and it will not be a problem at all to rack up the emeralds, as it were. Oh, I can't believe this is the last episode of this. It's been quite the ride, hasn't it? I had a big hiatus in the middle there with vacation and whatnot, but it feels so good to be back to finish it off. Is this you? Yeah. See, I could just do that to reset him, hopefully. I have not grown a lot of melons and stuff, so that is a thing that I haven't done. You butcher 16, 14. 14 is good. There you go. Refresh. Hey, little buddy. Whoa! That guy got really scared or something. Yeah, what's leave a comment below. Like, what's your favorite point of this series? What's your favorite memory that we've done? I honestly have to think about that for a minute before I answer. So while I trade up the last few things here in my inventory, where is the shepherd? There he is. Beautiful. 45 levels. So let me think about a few of the things we've done here and kind of have a little bit of a reminiscing moment. All right, let me just finish up my trades. Alright, it appears as though I have exhausted all my trades, and as you can tell, this is a very highly lucrative way of getting blocks or emeralds. And this is my preferred way of doing it, which is also driving me a little bit insane with these sounds. My god, these people and their humming and awing and geez. Let me just get out of here. Got an iron golem yet? I don't think there's enough guys in there currently. I do kill off the bad trade guys and unwanted guys. Sorry. So let's go underneath here and see if we can't get our stuff together. A little bit of a side thing I noticed here. I accidentally broke this block up here. And there was a head inside, so I was going to save it for when we were recording here. And but the thing is, this thing covered it up, and I feel like we should break all these together, you know? These are the monuments that, oh, okay. What about these guys? Still no heads. There was a head here, I swear. Hmm, this is so strange. Maybe I have a screenshot, I don't think I do, but... No, I can't get rid of them. Oh, strange, man. Well, either way, that's a little bit of a hidden feature, I suppose. That's annoying. I guess... Hey! Hey! Oh, fine. Roam free. But I guess, maybe I missed out on something by breaking the one, but not the rest. I feel like there should have been heads in all of these, but over time, they just close up. Or something happened with the new version. I don't know. I don't think I've updated. All right, here we are, guys. We would need a 9x9 area. And while I do this, I guess I can kind of reminisce and think about what the best moments of this series has been for me. Oh, geez, the first episodes are so long ago. But the first episode is always so great because you get a ton of achievement. You have no idea what is around you and whatnot. And it's just everything is fresh and good and new. So that is definitely a highlight, you know, in itself. But to me, the 4, 5, let me just count 6, 7, 8, 9, not 10. And the highlight for me has to be the dragon fight. That is one of the most fun dragon fights I've had. I died a few times. I took elements with, like, utilizing the elytra wings and whatnot. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Why do I always do that? And it's one of the episodes that just stick out to me. And this is why I don't build and talk at the same time ever, because this is hard as nails, man. My brain cannot process doing both of these things. I am a male. I cannot multitask. So... If you didn't know, you need 164 blocks to complete a full beacon. The more you know. The bottom layer here, it has to be 81 blocks. And the next one is 49, and then 25 and 9. Let's just hide these inside here, I suppose, so it's not too ugly. Any other episodes that stick out to me? There's also a few things I want to try before we end off, before I do the beacon. And, as I'm thinking about it, I'm not sure. I would like to hear what you guys think. Like, what has been the favorite moment in this series for you guys? I'm eager to find out. Do I even have enough blocks? Yeah, I'm pretty sure I do. I got more than enough. Pretty corner blocks, like so. And there we go. Leftover blocks, because I got so many emeralds. Awesome. That's pretty. Very nice. All right, let me get together the beacon. But there's also one more thing I wanted to try. So I've been saving something I found in a chest. There's the 3 guardian eggs. I want to spawn those just for fun. I see this as a little bit of a throwback to Captive Minecraft 3. Which, my god, it was so hard. That series was so hard to do, man. Ugh, what a pain. So long ago. Either way, let's do it. Yeah, you go to the water, jerk. Oh, whoa, don't shoot me. Yeah, I'm coming for you. So, in honor of Captive Minecraft 3, here we are. Can I even kill him? There I can. Hard to hit you. Come on. There we go. It's one way to get fish, I suppose. Did I even get fish? No. Alright, let's do the last two, just for fun. Because Captive Minecraft 3 is such a jerk butt, I feel like beating up these guys every time I see them. Sure are floppy. Sure are very floppy. No, I want to kill you with my sword. Either way, the beacon, as you probably know or not, I don't know, is... my god, this snow, though. Spirit of the game. We need glass. Do I have glass on the ready? I do believe I do in here. Yes. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 glass and obsidian. I should have a few in here. Indeed, 1, 2, 3, and our nether star. Where art thou, nether star? It should be in here, right? Yeah. Perfect. Oh, I'm excited for this. Just finishing it off in grandiose style. There it is, the beacon. Ah, let's do it. I don't know, I don't have any more words left in me. So I feel like I should just be quiet. I probably killed like 10 or so of these, whatchamacallit? The iron golems as well. Shame there was no guy here now, but here we go. This is it. Last achievement. Done. Now what do we do? Congratulations, there we go. I did beat Captive Minecraft! Ah, what a joyous occasion! Look at it! I beat it! I did it, Mom! All 34 Minecraft achievements. 53 hours! 26 minutes 48. Holy cow! 10 player deaths, that is correct. You get a little extra space. Look at it! It's expanding! World Boulder increased, and the option to take the Darkness Challenge. What's that? Whoa. Feel like, where's it? There. Darkness Challenge. You can begin the Darkness Challenge at any time by placing a torch on the quartz spawn block. Well, I suppose there should be like an encore episode, huh? For the darkness challenge? I don't know what that is, but I guess I'll check it out. And if it seems to be something interesting... Man, look at the space we have! Ugh. Is there, can we go to this guy now? Over here? No? He's still pretty far away. That guy. Hey, dude! Ugh, look at all this space. This is wonderful. Hello? Anyone out here? Go around this mountain, sort of. Darkness challenge, huh? Well, as far as this map is concerned, it is done. It has been done. I might do like an encore episode. If people are interested, leave me a comment below or a like on the video and I will let know that you're even remotely interested in the encore darkness challenge thingamajigger. Look at that torch. So dangerously close to starting it. Either way, there's that pig that I released up here. He's been just... He wandered up there and now he's been sitting there for the last... I don't know. Around the last 10 hours. 56 hours. That's a lot of idling time, though. Don't believe that I spent that time hardcore playing. There was a lot of AFK. I went away from the computer to play with my cat and whenever she called me and that kind of stuff. And I sat a lot of hours down at the skeleton farm that I made, AFK. And then, of course, the last bit here, I spent a lot of hours just... I closed myself in to watch, to wait for the wheat and all that to grow. Either way, as darkness falls, we have completed it. Let me take my helmet off so you can look at my beautiful face. Vanity. It is. Inside you. Alright. Well, for all intents and purposes, we did it. We completed the game. Completed the map. Thank you for all your support and love. It's been spurring me on and giving me inspiration and love and hope for the future. And until Captive Minecraft 5, excuse me, I've been the General. Thank you all for watching. At ease.